We visited Nib Sahendra, a surgeon and professor of endoscopy in Hamburg, Germany. Nib was born in Indonesia, educated in Germany, and is very much an international figure. He's an all-round endoscopist, known for many practical innovations, especially variceal sclerotherapy and therapeutic ERCP. He was the first to perform stenting.
Hi, I'm Nib Sahendra from the University Hospital Eppendorf in Hamburg, and we are here in a 1,500 beds hospital, where in the endoscopy unit, internist and surgeon working together, and in a year we are performing about 2,500 colonoscopies.
Zum Nierenspezialisten gehen.
Ja, da bin ich auch gewesen.
Christina muss noch ein bisschen zur Seite, glaube ich.
Wie heißt Christina, das? Das ist keine Endoskopie, sondern eine Blasenspiegelung.
Note the abdominal binder being applied, a Sahendra speciality, which he thinks avoids loops. It helps the nurses anyway, because he doesn't ask for hand pressure.
Das ist gut, da bin ich beruhigt. Jetzt drehen Sie mal wieder auf die linke Seite ganz rum, Sie kennen das ja. Und dann kriegen Sie die Spritze, bitte.
Because this was a fairly tough and looping insertion, we cut out around 5 minutes of the video. Nib usually does his colonoscopies with fluoroscopy. We used the 3D imager for this session, but he is not seeing it. Notice that he uses his nurse to steady the scope.
Muss jetzt wieder begradigt sein.
Ja, sieht super aus.
You can see what a good team he has around him.
So, das macht wieder left lecture hier. Going to the transverse column, I guess. If the column is not too long. Sucking the air to shorten the column and approaching the right flexure. Straightening again. So, this must be the second. The orifice of the appendix okay. Now we're going to remove to withdraw the scope the examination actually starting okay now.
Notice his endoscoping skills, a high standard of examination and subtle, careful scope handling.
No explanation for the diarrhea. How much propofol?
100.
He's talking about propofol and the unit's routine use of general anesthesia.
5 milligram diazepam. 5 milligram diazepam and 100 propofol is okay. It's not too much. I'm aspirating now so that the patient will not get discomfort after the examination. No recurrent polyp, I don't know. I was expecting after the diverticulosis here because of the symptom of the patient, but it's not.
A good point here, he's correctly taking about as long for this examination phase as he did for the insertion.
Ah, this is a scar from the previous pulpectomy. Mm-hmm. It's nice to see clear, no recurrence. A little diverticulum. I hear some more scar, two scars besides this other. You can make a documentation photo for our computer. Especially psychologically, it's good for the patient. Looking.
Note his good coordination between left hand up down and right hand twisting and in out movements. Scrupulous handling all around.
They usually have a plastic polyp. Look at that here. This is, I think, a diverticulum. Like a diverticulosis, no? Here. No, not here. Okay. We're going to finish. This is the rectum. Another scar is here. Larger one. Okay, now here, some more scar, a little bit hemorrhoid, yeah, the thrombosis of the paramo hemorrhoid at 1 o'clock, yeah. Very nice to see. Okay, that's it. Now we are forming the alpha loop, and in most of the cases, the alpha loop is forming by the anti-clockwise rotation. And the alpha loop usually is useful because it facilitates the advancement of the scope. So then I will leave it. As long as the patient is well sedated, I will leave the alpha loop forming. And start to straighten the scope immediately after passing the sigmoid colon. I usually only advance the scope when I see the lumen.
Could you explain what the nurse is doing?
The nurse is not doing, he's actually just holding the scope, preventing the scope to withdraw. So slip back. See, the lumen is upstairs. That means I will try to push a little bit, so I push this loop. You see the loop, the alpha loop is forming, but you can easily advance the scope. As long as the scope is advancing without to push too much. Now,
explain about the variable scope.
Now the variable scope is not, the scope is a variable scope, it's not stiffened at this moment because I'm going to straighten the scope. To straighten the scope, I usually rotate in the clockwise direction and fix the tip of the scope as well, simultaneously. Suck a little bit there. And jiggling a little bit. Have the lumen under control to prevent putting back of the scope. And suck the air. And if the scope is completely straight, you have the pill here. I'm wondering if there is still a loop there. I will see. I'm trying to rotate to scale the scope. First anti-clockwise. And then, no, first clockwise direction and then anti-clockwise.
Of course, it wasn't actually an alpha loop. Nib simply pushed through an N spiral loop. The patient didn't complain because of the anesthesia. But he's a skilled endoscopist, so he's trying to straighten out the loop.
The position of the scope is not very stable in this moment. So now, as soon as scope is straightened, you can use the stiffening facilities. I will suck a little bit, aspirate the air. By aspirating the air, the colon become a little bit shorter. But with the probe inside, of course, the suction facility is not optimal. Okay, now, advance the scope after stiffening. Look for the lumen.
So, do you like the stiffening facility?
I like very much the stiffening facility. I think this is this is a good tool, not only for the beginners, as we taught in the beginning, but also for the expert. I'm not counting me as an expert, but I have had a fun experience in colonoscopy. So at the beginning, I thought we don't need that. But if you have that, you will use this facility increasingly because it saves also the time. So whenever you like to straighten the scope, it is advisable to remove the stiffening. I think there's a stick tomorrow either, if I'm right. It's not possible.
Okay, on the right side is the indication.
Yeah. Okay, we will turn the patient first to the supine. Okay? We're going to turn the patient to the right side.
Oh. That's another of the problems of general anesthesia. It's tough to change position.
If this is not sufficient, then we will continue to turn the patient to the right lateral. So that this scope, the 160, CF160AI, has an extra small channel here. We can connect it with the water pump. And we're going to show you. And this is, I think, very useful additional facility of this scope. So especially if you're dealing with a dirty colon or for example in the acute colonic bleeding, then you can create a very nice water jet. Connected now?
You can.
Okay. Now you see the water jet?
Is that a foot pedal?
We have the foot pedal here. You see the water jet, very nice and very strong. So it's much better than to inject the water through the biopsy channel. And the total, the amount of the water inside will be also decreased.